Hey everyone, Elisa with Jots Designs. In this video, I am going to be doing a suggestion that I got from one of my patrons on Patreon and see how the bubble effect with UV resin and some dish soap works on wood. And if you haven't seen my first bubble effect video, definitely check it out as I explain the process a bit more. And I also wanted to do some tests with some dye, and I've got some Folk Art Ultra Dye. And I've got the tantalizing teal, the turquoise, and the blue bayou, and I'm gonna stain the wood first and then use the resin on top of that. And then I also wanted to test out what coloring the resin would do, and I'm gonna be using some powders, dusty teal, deep purple, and earth red from Rez. And I'm also gonna be doing another test where I color the resin with some Breakfast at Tiffany fine glitter. And those powders and that glitter I got from Laura's Art Corner, and there's definitely links below for all the products that I've used, except for the dish soap, because it really doesn't matter which dish soap you use. And I was pretty pleased with these tests. Let me know what you think of them in the comments below, and which one's your favorite. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and turn that bell on so you know when I upload videos. All right, so I'm actually gonna start with the glitter. And for the bubbles, I've just got a tall Tupperware container and I'll add some soap to it. And less than half of it is full of water. That way I have room to grab the bubbles without actually touching the waters. Give that a good shake. And I've got my UV lamp ready to go. It's a 36 watt lamp and it has a removable tray, which comes in pretty handy. And just a note here, I didn't prep any of the wood in any way, and that's really because I knew I wouldn't have the resin on the wood uncured for very long. So I didn't really need to worry about it seeping into the wood like I would with a two-part epoxy. And also these were just tests, so I didn't need to, you know, be perfect or fancy or anything with them. All right, so I've got the glitter mixed in and I'm just adding a little bit here. I didn't want to use too much UV resin because again, these are just tests. So just enough to know what happens. And I'm gonna add in the bubbles, and then once I tap those down, I'm gonna put the UV light on there and get it cured. And this light has two settings, and I believe it was on the 3 minute time. Basically, if it's still a little tacky, just cook it a little bit longer and you should be good. I'm just gonna wipe off the bubbles and the wetness here, and you can see that the wood is actually wet. So if you do this and you don't prep the wood, definitely make sure you let it dry before you do anything else. Otherwise, it could affect whatever you're doing. Okay, so just for this one, I grabbed some more dye, and I got the orange, it's Lady Marmalade, and I'm just gonna paint the rest of the heart with that. And then I'm gonna work on the ones with the powder. So I'll get that all mixed up and just pour that on. Again, I'm not doing the whole heart. I wanted to do another test with this one, but I got the bubbles on, get that cured, and it came out, and the edges were pretty rough. Just the way that the bubbles kind of pushed the resin along the edges and stuff. So what I did is just grabbed a nail file. And this is kind of my go-to for edges like this. It's easy to hold and isn't too flexible like a piece of sandpaper or something. So just sanded those down. And I wanted to do another quick test before I did more on this one, because I wanted to see what putting clear resin over the bubbled effect would do. So I just grabbed a little wooden token that I had and used the same colors, did the bubbles, and then added the clear on top. And I actually really liked it. I like the red a little bit more, and I think it's just because I added a bit more and it's a little bit more opaque. So with the powders, definitely go more on the opaque side and it'll show up better. And then I grabbed some Clearcast 7000, some Artisu Egyptian Blue, and Rez Angel White. And I'm just gonna cover this up, starting with some clear, adding in that blue, and then adding in some white, and just moving that around with the airbrush and the torch, and just kind of playing around, seeing what it would look like over the bubbles areas, as well as right next to it and whatnot. And I really like actually how the white moved over the bubbles. It gives it a little bit of an extra texture. So I just played around with that some more, and I will definitely show you close-ups of everything at the end again, and you'll see how awesome that kind of gave it an extra little bit of a texture. So with this one, I am just staining the wood with the dye, and I'm just following the grains, and then I'm gonna do just the top corner here with the UV resin, get a little bit on there, spread it around. Again, I'm not doing really thick layers or anything, just enough to get it covered and get that texture of the bubbles in there. And I got that cured, and I actually really like how this one turned out because it looks more like bubbles on it. The way that the light hits it. And here is just a little chunk of tree that I have, and I wanted to see what it would do to see the little cracks in the wood. And I think it turned out pretty cool. You could still see all the bubble effect. It's pretty awesome. But what I was hoping for was seeing the little cracks and crevices of the wood underneath. And of course, that just kind of disappeared because of the shapes of the bubbles. But I like how they turned out. This little one is great. You can see it a lot better than with the white resin over it, but you could see that texture in that white there. These are pretty cool. Again, the glitter, it's harder to see the bubbles in there, but you can definitely see them. I like the stained wood one because it looks more like bubbles on there. And here's some close-ups for you. This is that texture. You could see that extra like wavy texture over where the bubble area is, and then the general cells where there weren't any bubbles. And then this one, again, the metallic powders are great. That glitter is awesome. Definitely get those Rez products and the glitters from Laura's Art Corner. There's a discount down below along with all the products that I've used. And let me know what you guys think of these and which one is your favorite. I like the orange and the turquoise. I mean, I'm partial to those colors, but this wood is pretty cool. I think just putting clear resin over the wood would have been better for this piece, so you could see all those little cracks in there. But either way, good tests. Let me know what you think. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, check out my Facebook, Instagram pages, and my Amazon shop. If you want to help with project ideas, definitely join my Patreon, and I will see you guys later.